you want to lay out with somebody. You need to lay out with a bar of soap. Tell them that.
Some viewers may find the following video disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
Before we get into this video, please make sure you go check out my sponsor, Ebony Life. Ebony Life is a Black woman discussion app where we can go and discuss all of our problems, okay? It was made just for us. It is a safe space so that we can express how we feel whenever we want. If you want more details, go down in the description or in my pinned comment down below. Make yourself an account and get started today.
I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today,
Sage, what do you want?
Mm-hmm. Sage is mad because I'm ignoring her, okay? And today's reaction, I think, is gonna really break my heart. Because based on the title, I'm just like, well then. Today's video is going to be us reacting to a mother basically dragging her child on the internet. But she's dragging her on the internet for poor hygiene. Now, this is the thing. I grew up with this one girl, and that's the reason I really wanted to react to this. I had a friend in high school. Basically, me and my friends used to buy her stuff because, well, her stepmom was just like the evil stepmom type shit. Like the shit that you see on Disney, that was her. And it was to the point where like her mom used to take soap away from her, used to take deodorant away from her, and she would always smell. And people always used to make fun of her in school. And it got to a point where, you know, we asked her like, yo, like, you clearly know there's something going on with you. Like, what's going on? Like, you know, we had to tell her because we were hanging out with her every day. And we were like, yo, like, what's good? What's up? And she was just like, you know, she told us like, yeah, my stepmom takes soap away from me. She won't let me have lotion. She won't let me have tampons, pads, anything. Like, so her stepmother was just being very, very petty to her, all types of shit. So we used to buy her stuff. So I was like, you know what? It would be interesting to see exactly what these types of mothers say to their children. And also, if you are going through this, I am so sorry, because that's a very tough situation to go through, especially if you're like so young to the point where you can't get a job and you can't buy your own stuff. It sucks. So Sage, I'm sorry, but I'm filming. I'm gonna have to put you down. Look at her, bro. She is like comfortable. Are you gonna say hi? Hi! Okay, she said put me down. I got you. I don't understand how people could like not like their kids or be genuinely mean to their kids. Like it hurts to think about. Like, I don't even have a kid yet, and it just really bothers me that people could be that heartless to something that they produce. Like, you wanna degrade this kid for what? Like, what did the kid do to you? Like, I don't know, y'all. I don't know. This is gonna be interesting. Before we start, comment down below. Do you have parents that were mean to you? Whether it was your dad, your mom, or just a legal guardian, adoptive, step, whatever. Did you have a parent that was genuinely mean to you? Why? Or do you know why? Do you not know why? Like, let me know down below, because I'd love to know.
There we go. This right here is a video of how nasty Remy rides.
Oh, Jesse. I need more water. For the sake of me almost choking on dry air, some of y'all probably watching this and y'all probably eating, drinking. I'm gonna block out what this is. Y'all don't want to see what's on the screen right now. I'm gonna tell you what's on the screen, but you don't want to see. Basically, it's a dirty female product. I don't want to watch that. Yeah, I'm just gonna listen.
This is the pissy pad she had on. This is the one she kept on all day. This is this hair she keeps trying to wrap around her head that smells like shit. These are the pants she wear almost every day that she don't never wash. These are the ones that she pissed in and she kept them on. Those pink things are the panties that don't belong to her, they belong to someone else. Those sneakers are the ones that y'all been seeing her wear in school and they smell like shit. Let's see. This is the bathroom she takes a fucking shower in that she refuses to clean, which is very nasty, and it's their own bathroom.
I'm sorry. Pause. First of all, my thing is, if she's so dirty, where you think she learned that from? Okay, mom. Okay, Mr. Clean. Like,
You must be salop too. You must be dirty too, my friend. You must be dirty too. What are you talking about? You can't complain about your kid being some type of way and not attribute it to you. Now, I'm not going to say if your kid turns out to be a serial killer, you have serial killer tendencies. I'm not saying that. But I'm saying, if your kid turns out a certain type of way that you didn't want them to turn out, 9 times out of 10, it's because something you did or did not do. I'm just saying. Where did your daughter learn this dirty? If she's so dirty, where's she learning from? Dirty ain't innate, but okay.
And put your hand down. Show the world who you are.
This is petty.
You gotta stand up now.
This is petty.
Stand up. You're proud to be on Facebook. You should be proud to be shown on Facebook. I don't care, but you're on here when you shouldn't be. When you should, I don't give a fucking rat's ass. When you should be in a fucking book. Let's get that straight. Who felt they regis for the past 3 years? Let's get that straight.
All right, I'm sorry. This is not okay on or offline. There's ways to talk to people. And for whatever reason, people treat their kids like property and they treat their kids as if you don't, like they don't need to speak to them in a way that is conducive to them being a human. I have to give a special shout out to BGL Jewelry. Shop them for all your black girl needs, okay? Homegirl sent me a nice little clip, y'all. It says melanin, y'all. I used to see this on the gram and be like, oh, I want one of these. Now I could do the little Instagram picture. Hold up. That's what these bitches be doing. I love it. And then she sent me this brick. Oh shit, where's the bracelet? My wrist is getting smaller these days. It's red and blue. I don't know if she did this intentionally because I'm Haitian, but I love it. And then she sent me these earrings that said melanin as well. She also sent me this necklace. This is my favorite thing. It says brown skin girl. I don't think y'all can see it, but it's so beautiful. And I just, oh, I love it so much. So yeah, shop them. Go get your stuff today. Very affordable, super cute. Be proud of your melanin, live in your melanin, and most importantly, support black business. Also support good business. Go shop. Everything you need is down in the description or in the pinned comment down below. People like to say that, you know, their kids are their property or their boyfriend, their girlfriend, whatever. People around them are their property. People that they own, people they're in relationships with are their property, but with all respect, they're human at the end of the day. They are their own person and you should treat everyone with respect unless they disrespect you first. In this case, I'm not gonna say that she disrespected her, didn't disrespect her, because I don't know. But I'm saying, like, this is really some fucked up shit. It's unnecessary and I feel really bad for this girl. Like, because even if she wasn't to do this online, this would be fucked up. Like, it's just, oh God.
Are you telling that? I can't hear you. Is that a lie?
No.
Oh, okay. Have you passed your regents? Have you passed
Why
it?
She had to do
My
that?
My point exactly. But you on Facebook.
What's wrong, Sam?
You can't even wash your ass properly, but you on fucking Facebook. You gotta be told to brush your fucking teeth, wash your ass, turn around and make sure between your legs smell good, because it don't, because you're walking around with a pad on all fucking day. Show that! You know what time I say you want to lay out with somebody? You need to lay out with a bar of soap. Tell them that.
She had to do that. I'm sorry, that was a funny joke, but she had to do that. Damn, she said you need to lay down. Wait, I need to put this water down. First of all, I'm using that, not on a kid, because this is fucked up. But damn, she did not have to come at her like that. Dang, like, she looks so heartbroken. I feel so bad for this kid right now for the simple fact that that's just petty. Like, there's a ways to talk to your kid to get through them. You don't have to embarrass them, degrade them like this. Whether it's online or at home, this is just not the way to do it. It's really fucked up, and I genuinely don't understand why a lot of parents resort to this way, unless, you know, it's been done to them. Like, clearly, if someone did this to you, if you were raised this way, you would think it's okay. But I don't know. Like, I just don't think this is conducive to a positive relationship between you and your child. Like, it just doesn't make sense. Like, if my parents would have talked to me like this, I would have fucking moved to Arkansas. I would not give a fuck. Part of the only reason I'm here in Jersey is because my parents never treated me like shit. Sure, they didn't pay bills. Sure, we were homeless and shit. But my parents never really treated me like shit. They're not affectionate. They're not the best. But
they never treated me like this. Like this, I would not move my ass to motherfucking Alaska. My parents treated me like this. This is horrible.
This Facebook fucking queen.
First of all, she don't look cute with damn self in the mirror.
You like being on it, right? I don't give a fuck if you on it for 5 seconds, you illiterate bastard. With the grades that you come home with, you shouldn't be on it at all. Look.
Wait. You got the nerve to call your kid a bastard? Why'd you get a bastard? Alright, two can play that game. You just called her an illiterate bastard. Did you read to her when she was a kid? Did you help her with her homework? Even Sage, you heard that meow? Even Sage is like, yes, sis. Like, what? Why is your kid illiterate? And then you calling your kid a bastard? Why is your kid a bastard? Did you marry her father? Did you make sure that he was someone suitable to have kids with? Do you guys know what the definition of a bastard is? How the hell do you have the nerve to call your kid a bastard when it's most likely your fault that your kid is a bastard? Who you laying with, sis? Illiterate? Bastard? Whose fault is that, sis? Nah, bro. I would have had to hook up with my mom's as soon as she said some shit like that. I would have like, all right, square the fuck up and call the cops or I'll call them for you.
Fucking dumbfounded. Go ahead. Let us start check who went to summer school. Who went to summer school? Oh, my point exactly. And this is what she looked like on a fucking regular. Funky and fucked up. Pretty fucking nasty. This is Mariah, the real fucking Mariah. Very fucking nasty. It smells.
Oh, God.
That's what you need to show since you want to put everything else out there, motherfucker. Show that.
Can we not have this on the screen?
Your Facebook fucking naked, probably. Because you have no respect for yourself. I don't play that shit. You want to put something up there? Put the fucking facts. And this is the facts. She's disgusting. Had to tell her to get up this morning and take the first bloody one off. It was pissy.
You know what I want to know? For real, let's be real here, right? And I know a lot of people are going to be very upset when they say this, but how many of these mothers like to do this to their sons? Cricket! 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 I only see these videos of mothers doing this to their daughters, and no, it's not just black mothers. Before you white crusaders come running to the motherfucking comments saying, bullshit, you will be blocked. I have moderators for that. The point is, why is it always mothers dragging their daughters like this? Is it jealousy? Is it hatred? Is it pure concern that they don't know how to express? Because it's very interesting to me that this always seems to be mother dragging her daughter type of situation when it comes to these online situations. I feel so bad for this girl. All right, now this video is from Horatio Radio. I hope I said that right. I'm going to link it down in the description box below so you guys can hear his commentary. And now I'm going to give my commentary. Some people shouldn't fucking have kids. Point blank period. Some people shouldn't have kids. Some people really shouldn't be able to give life in this world for the simple fact that that's a very important role that you have in a new human being's life. At the end of the day, it's yours, you know, you did make it, but it's still an individual. It's still a human who has feelings, who has its own life, who has its own path, who has everything going for itself. And it's up to you to foster, to nurture, to guide this little human to being a great adult and great member of society that is able to contribute. I personally do not understand why it is that people will have kids and still treat them like shit. When it's their own kid, and then their kid is a reflection of them. You can't sit there and drag your kid when they're that young and then try to say that it has nothing to do with you. Try to say that it's all their fault. She's mad young. She's growing up still. She's clearly going to have certain tendencies, especially if you have not instilled specific types of tendencies in her. And if you have, then talk to her about why she's doing the things that she's doing. How hard is it to talk? Why are people, why? Why can't we have conversation? Why do we have to always resort to dragging someone? Why do we always have to resort to like legit being rude, legit being mean, legit being like, why? Like, I understand if you constantly had to do or say something, but even if that was the case in this situation, she could have done that in private.
It didn't have to be a,
oh, I keep telling you to change your pissy pad. I keep telling you to take a shower. I keep telling you to change your weave and you don't want to. You dirty. I'm putting you on Facebook.
Why is that a parenting tactic? People always want to blame the current generation and the generation after that and generation after that for certain behaviors. But it's like, you got to look at generation before that. People do always want to come at us millennials. But you know what? Now that I think about it, us millennials ain't shit, and I feel very, very afraid to see this next wave of motherfucking children. They're gonna be very, very socially aware, so that's gonna be cute. But the wave of embarrassing children will definitely, definitely keep on going. And people will continue to repost these videos, and I will continue to speak on them. So comment down below, have you had this experience? Do you know anyone who has had this experience? Let me know down in the comment section below. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, follow me on social media, get your merchandise, and I'm gonna see y'all next time.